Is Ivanka here? Ivanka, you here?
Hello?
Oh, Don.
Daddy.
Oh, well, okay. That's who I was hoping would call. How are you, Ivanka?
Daddy Bolton says you can talk your way out of anything. I hope that doesn't include our very special relationship.
No, I try to talk my way, into a more special relationship. I wouldn't want to talk my way out of this, what we have. It's a great, great father-daughter.
I love when you call me your son. It gives me that rush.
Well, it's when you have, I have Don Jr., you've had to be like the great daughter and the great son because, with Don Jr. and Eric, it's like between the two of them, I don't feel like I have one son.
You've got three daughters, though.
I do. Well, yes. I know, you're like three daughters. I mean, you're so tremendous that it's almost like, Ivanka, you could be three people, like a wife, a daughter, and a friend. You're almost three different roles you could play. It's a beautiful thing.
Well, I love when we role play, but let's not go there right now, okay, Daddy? Daddy, I totally...
I love it. See now what you're doing right there.
Daddy.
That I've said it. When you say Daddy, I love it when you say Daddy.
Daddy, I totally don't get why Uncle Johnny, Mr. Bolton, thinks you're so moody and vindictive and full of yourself. I mean, I am totally attracted to you and Jared for having those very traits.
Well, I know he's sort of he's like the diet version of me, Jared Kushner. But I think that Bolton, I think he's such an angry guy because he had all those, he's a failed musician. He had a couple of hits in the 1980s. And then, you just look at him, he looks terrible now. He used to have some talent, and now he's just an angry guy with a walrus mustache.
I think he used to use his mustache hairs for the strings on his instrument, Daddy.
He might have. He very well might have.
I think he did. I think that's something that he might do just to impress you.
Well, he's not impressing me anymore. His book is going to be a failure, and it's full of lies and lies and classified material. We can't have either of those things, and they're both terrible for the country, terrible for us. And I hope his book fails. I know it's going to fail, and I want to get in more of a good mood. Obviously, I'm in Arizona right now with this great faith rally we're having at a church. It's going to be just a strong...
I love when you talk God, Daddy. Please talk God.
Well,
please.
And I love it when you call out to God. When I walk by you and
God,
room
God,
at night and I hear you.
God.
I especially like it when you're very prayerful. When you're
God.
I got to be honest, though. When you're with Jared, I don't think you don't sound as excited as, in other years when I would walk by your room late at night.
God.
I will say that faith is very important to all of us. Obviously, we're different faith now that you... I think you had the fingers crossed when you did the whole conversion, but still, we're different. We're sort of different faiths, but that's okay.
I just wanted to produce the yarmulkes in my sweatshops.
Well,
Daddy.
They're beautiful yarmulkes, I think they're pronounced, but I think they're beautiful.
You have such a good accent. I love when you do different languages, Daddy.
I'm great friends with Bibi Netanyahu, the great Israeli king. Okay, they call Jesus king of the Jews, but I really think it's Bibi.
Bibi. Say Bibi again, Daddy.
Bibi.
Thank you. Daddy,
as
some reporter...
to what I prefer, which are DDs, if you know what I mean. I think you know what I mean, because I think we still have the receipts from yours.
I always know what you mean, Daddy. Daddy, some reporter said that Mr. Bolton's revelations have a level of intimacy never before seen in a book. And Daddy, how much did you tell Bolton about us?
Well, I told, I said that you're, such a talented, beautiful person, okay? And that a lot of people know this because I've said this other places, that if you weren't my daughter, we might be dating. And I think that's the highest compliment a father can give to a daughter.
I get high off your compliments, Daddy. I love hearing that. I especially loved when you thought about my having boobies when I was only a kid. I thought that was cool.
I thought that was Tiffany.
Tiffany, Daddy. I thought that was about me.
It was about Tiffany.
Who's Tiffany?
Let's see.
That's Marla's daughter, Donald. Marla's, your other daughter. Tiffany Trump. Tiffany Trump, and she graduated from Georgetown Law School, and you didn't say a word about it.
Well, I mean, it's a good school. It's no Harvard, but, you know, good for her, whoever she is. You know, it's funny we have the same last name, but, you know, Trump is not the most uncommon name. I'm sure there's other, you know, every person with the last name Brown doesn't have to find the richest person named Mr. Brown and then, you know, get a message. But it's good for her, whoever she is.
I once met a Muhammad Trump. Does that matter?
First of all, I don't think there are any Muhammad Trumps.
No, I swear to God, Daddy. I swear I would never lie to you.
Well, I wouldn't let them in the country, so I hopefully met them at another, you know, in a foreign country,
yeah,
because we've put a total ban on Muhammad Trumps.
It was on one of my trips with Jared to make us look like we knew what we were doing. We went to other countries. Daddy?
Well, you know, you have great talent. We're grooming you for 2024, by the way. I mean, not to break news on this program. I think Don Jr. thinks, you know, he got like a sort of a store brand version of my wife Melatonin to be his girlfriend. But to be honest, we all know it's going to be you. Don Jr. is just going to, you know, continue to hunt defenseless animals and do CrossFit with poor technique. And you're the one we're looking at for 2024.
Ooh, well, you know, I've always loved when you groomed me. So that's very,
we're gonna call,
very flat.
We're going to call the campaign 2036-24-36.
That's so clever. Can we put that on a hat?
I think we can.
Daddy, the book talks about John Kelly, and does it still bother you that he called you a fucking idiot instead of just an idiot?
Well, I think, you know, as many Playboy Playmates can attest to, the fucking part is definitely true. The idiot part is the part that I take great, you know, John Kelly is an angry guy from, you know, like Boston people, they're always so angry. And, you know, I think he's a loser. He thought he could control me. He didn't have the talent or the strength to control me. And he's a loser. And now he's complaining now that he's out of work.
Did you ever try on his uniform, Daddy?
Just the helmet. I role played with Madagascar. And we would, I would put on the helmet and order her around, and it was good because she's required to obey me twice a month per our strong prenup. So it was good.
Hey, so
I really want you to wear the helmet again.
We saw the news
report. Excuse me, you don't interrupt great Ivanka, okay? She allows you to speak, you may talk.
Sorry.
I wanted to hear more of Ivanka.
You're so good at not paying attention, Daddy. That's what I love about you most. Is that
the greatest thing in the world, the greatest gift a father can have is a daughter that sounds like a phone sex operator.
Yes.
It is
Thank
the greatest
you.
Gift anywhere,
Thank
I think.
You. Thank you, Daddy, so much. Thank you.
Now, I just heard some audio of Ivanka talking from a few years ago. And funny, your voice wasn't as breathy. You didn't sound like this. Did something happen, Ivanka, to make you all whispery like that?
I took elocution lessons, Nicole.
Oh, I see.
So that when I went out on stage with my father, who you were speaking to on the other line, that I would sound mature and ready to lead.
Okay.
It's called breath augmentation. Okay, that's the process. Breath augmentation. It's a great, we're going to be selling it at a Trump Tower soon. She can teach the class. It's a great sort of technique. It makes the person sound so much more sort of competent and sexy. It's a great combination.
Oh, breath augmentation.
Breath augmentation. Got it.
Breath augmentation. Daddy likes when I say things that he says back to him so that he can hear them in slightly different intonations. Breath augmentation, Daddy.
It's a great thing to hear. It makes me, you know, it's, you know, sometimes I'll just, when I'm with my wife, Mylanta, I'll have her, we'll just play tapes that Ivanka's recorded.
Uh-huh.
It's
like
true.
The soundtrack.
But I heard that Melanoma and Ivanka don't really get along too well.
I hate her. Oh, I'm sorry.
No, and that's, you know, that's going to be natural because obviously Melatonin is the new, so, you know, the third, we call her the third first lady. And that's a lot, you know, that's tough because obviously I'm always going to have special feelings for Ivanka, but you know, it's, you know, you have to have somebody that you're not related to by blood as the first lady. So,
yes.
But, you know, if I wasn't in office right now, I think we'd probably be divorced already. So.
Yeah, I think you probably would. Oh, I know what I was going to ask you about. That melanoma renegotiated your prenup before she'd move into the White House back when you first moved to Washington, D.C. So did you give her what she wanted?
Well, you know, let's be honest, okay? The Be Best campaign does not apply to her reading of English skills. So she thought she was being tough and doing the renegotiation, but we gave her, like, I'd say a few extra dollars a month.
Uh-huh.
Okay, but what I got in return was incredible, and I don't think she even realizes how strong the renegotiation went for me. You know, for instance, on my birthday, which passed recently, on Flag Day, great patriotism, I received a hall pass, which was not in the original prenup. So she had to leave for the day, and then we had, you know, we had a friend, actually two friends, come over to the White House for the birthday, and it was, you know, she didn't realize that she had signed that away. So I think it went much stronger for me, to be honest.
Oh, okay.
Daddy always wins. Daddy is a winner.
I'm going to jump in here because we are getting close to the end of the hour. So I need to let everybody know who our Donald Trump is. And J.L. Cauvin, you are just fucking brilliant. You are just you are so fucking great at this.
Oh,
his name is J.L., letter J dash letter L, Cauvin, C-A-U-V-I-N. And you need to check out his YouTube channel because he does Donald Trump. Like every day there's another video. And your voice, you have the inflection down. You have all of his weird audible ticks, things like, yeah, he's just,
sure,
you're
well,
just that good.
You.
So thank you for jumping in. I mean, we talked about doing this a while ago because Laffy does such a great Ivanka and you do the best Donald
that I've
heard.
Feeling uncomfortable. I guess that proves that I'm not fully immersed in the Donald Trump character like I thought because I kept thinking, I feel like this is inappropriate what I'm thinking with this voice. I'm supposed to be her father. What is this?
It is really kind of creepy.
I felt dirty talking to you, but not for the same reason.
Very sultry, and I feel like that's exactly what the real Donald Trump would love to hear. Which
exactly,
is
right?
Absolutely. And to answer, I mean, I was watching the YouTube chat room while you guys were doing this, and I got to say, all we did, I introduced them via email, but the two of you didn't plan anything. This was all improv.
Didn't.
This was all
improv. We never even went past one sentence on the email.
Right?
This is like brand new.
That was great. This was just
this
so
great.
Much fun.
I love you. I love you, JL.
You were great, too. That was a lot of fun.
Oh, that thanks. Was fun. And I think Ivanka and Donald are going to have to get together, you know, occasionally in the future as we move
we'll
on.
We'll have another rendezvous, Daddy.
Yes. So, JL.
Sounds, well, of course, I think we will.
Your YouTube channel, is there an easy link to it, or should I just post it on the blog where I post the podcast?
Oh, I guess, you know, it's just youtube.com/JL-Cauvin.
There you go.
So I guess that's
it.
So,
well, I will put a link on the blog at NicoleSandler.com where I post the show. J.L. Cauvin, you're great. Thank you for helping us laugh at the insanity that's going on in D.C. You're great, and I'm so thankful that you joined us for this. This was a treat.
Thanks again.
All
right. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
All right. All right.
Thanks.
Bye. Nice seeing you, Laffy.
Thanks, J.L.
All right.
Bye.
And Laffy, we're out of time for another week. So this was, this was good. We needed a laugh right about now, I think.
Oh, we did, didn't we? Oh,
we
boy.
Did.
Now I just need a trough of wine and I'll be fine.
Yeah, I think I'll go imbibe in something too. Tomorrow on the program, Jeff Charlotte will be here. Jeff Charlotte, the man behind the family, has an amazing series article in Vanity Fair that you got to read. Anyway, got to go. We're done. Thank you, Laffy. Thank you, JL.
Thank you.
Thank you, listeners. You guys rock. We'll see you tomorrow on the Nicole Sandler Show. Bye.